Hi everyone, here in this lecture we are going to talk about what are the events that take place after the fertilization, or you may say that how the medulla and the blastocyst is formed. So before we see, let me draw the diagram first here. So here it is the uterus, and there it is the uterine tube, and this is the finger-like ending of this uterine tube. There it is, the wall of the uterus. Here it is the myometrium, and this one is the endometrium, that is innermost lining of the uterus, and there it is the female gonad, that is ovary. So if you remember, or you can see in my previous video, that we have studied how the ovulation takes place. So ovulation means it is happening on the day of 14. It means the mid of the cycle, in which from the ovary there is a mature graafian follicle or the tertiary follicle, and in the tertiary follicle there is a secondary oocyte which is released on the day of 14, and finally this secondary oocyte is picked up by this finger-like end of fallopian tube, and this secondary oocyte is covered by a layer of zona pellucida here, and also surrounded by few granulosa cells, that is corona radiata, covering these zonal layer. So this is how on the day of ovulation this secondary oocyte is released from this female gonad and pick up by this fallopian tube. So this secondary oocyte then move toward the widest and longest part of the uterine tube, that is called the ampullary part or the ampulla. Here it is the secondary oocyte, and this secondary oocyte remain here . This is the zonal layer, and it is covered by again the layer of granulosa cells, and these granulosa cells here known as the corona radiata. So this secondary oocyte remain here viable for about 12 to 24 hours, so that it may be able to fertile during that period. So on the day of ovulation, this graafian follicle releases one secondary oocyte into the fallopian tube, and this cell or this secondary oocyte is waiting for about 12 to 24 hours, and if at that time ejaculation is happen and the sperm cells releases from the vagina and by the root of uterus, these sperm cells, if it reach near the secondary oocyte, what will be happening? The important step that is going to be take place here is that the fertilization. So by the fusion of the sperm cells with the secondary oocyte forms a single cell, that is called zygote, and the process which is going to be take place here to complete this formation is called fertilization. So in my previous video we have seen how this fertilization takes place, and how these sperm cells, finally many of the sperm cells being attached with this zonal layer of the secondary oocyte here, they all are trying to get inside the secondary oocyte, but the first cell which touches the plasma membrane of the secondary oocyte, that is ulema, get the chance to go inside the secondary oocyte and share its genetic material with this secondary oocyte. And by this process, what is forming here is next is the zygote. So here it is, the zygote. This is the diploid cell, and here this diploid cell is covered by a layer of zona pellucida here. It means this layer is still intact. So by the fusion of these two haploid cells, one sperm cell and one secondary oocyte, what is forming here? The diploid mononucleated cell, that is called zygote. This zygote goes into continuous division, that is binary division, or you can say the mitotic division, in which this one cell divide and form two, then it divide to form four cells, then to six cells, not eight cells, and then it divide to form 16 cells, then onwards. So this is how this zygote, mononucleated single cell, goes into the cleavage, or it divide itself and forms the 2, 4, 8, 16 cell structures in the uterine tube. So here we'll see how this division is going to take place. By the binary division, it forms 2 cell structure. Here it is. And this 2 cell stage, this is called 2 cell stage. And this stage completes within 30 hours after fertilization. So the haploid number of chromosomes in the sperm and the secondary oocyte fuse together and form the diploid zygote. And as it forms the zygote after fertilization within 30 hours, what is happening here is that cleavage or the division take place, which is forming the one cell into the 2 cell stage within 30 hours of fertilization. After 2 cell stage, again because it is going into the continuous division, it forms later on the 4 cell stage and then 8 cell stage and finally the 16 cell stage structure. So what is happening here? After 30 hours of fertilization, it forms 2 cell stage, and later on by the continuous division, it forms the 4 cell stage and then the 8 cell stage and the 16 cell stage. And as it forms the 16 cell stage structure here, this is called the modula. And at what time it is going to be complete here? This stage is 96 hours after fertilization, or you can say after spending 3 days in the uterine tube or the fallopian tube. After the fertilization, this zygote is ultimately converted into the morula, that is 16 stage structure. When? That is after 96 hours. As you can see here, that the actual cell mass in the zygote, here you can see, is completely similar to that of modula. It means the cell size is not increasing, whereas in the cell mass is the same, and the dividing cells are become more smaller and smaller and smaller, but the cell masses remain similar as it was in the zygote. Is that clear? So the morula is forming here at the 16 cell stage, and it resembles like a mulberry. Still it is situated in uterine tube itself. So after spending 3 days in the uterine tube, morula goes inside the uterine cavity on the day 4th or 5th, and as this structure goes inside this uterine cavity, what is happening here is that the Cantor's division is going to take place. So this 16 cell structure became the 32 and then to 64 cell stage. And finally, there are many channels or the canaliculi on this zonal layer. And at this time, the uterus in the secretory phase, so it releases some fluid inside this structure by these channel. So as this fluid came into the structure, what is happening? These cells rearrange themselves, and some of the cell align themselves on the periphery, some of the cell arrange themselves on periphery. Here it is. And the cell which are arranging on the periphery, here it is, are called the outer cell mass. And few of the cell group together and they form cluster on one of the edge here. These are called, I am drawing in different so that you can be easily differentiate. So these are called inner cell mass. So the cell within this structure of the morula, by receiving some fluid from this uterine cavity, they rearrange themselves, some on the periphery or the rim, and these are called the outer cell mass, which is very important structure, which is going to later form the placenta and the fetal membrane. And some of the cell group together and remain on a one edge, and there it is called the inner cell mass. So the structure which is forming here on the day 5 or 6, it is called the blastocyst. The blastocyst, and the structure is called blastocyst, and the cell within this blastocyst, these cells are called blastomere. So the cell are called the blastomere, which lying inside this blastocyst cavity. Is that clear? Now the further differentiation takes place. As this fluid goes inside this structure continuously, what is happening? Now this blastocyst become more enlarged. Is that clear? And again it differentiate its outer cell mass, the peripheral cell which lying on this rim, to become change into the trophoblast. Or you can say the trophectoderm. Trophectoderm or the trophoblast. And the group of structure, here it is, the group of structure which are clumped together and rest on one edge, which are inner cell mass, they differentiate and forms later on the embryoblast. So this is how the cells within this blastocyst later on differentiate into the trophoblast, the outer one, and the inner one, which group together forms the embryoblast. And later on, by this fluid collection inside this blastocyst, slowly digest this zonal layer, it become thin, and finally it breaks off. So as this lining breaks off, it is ready to be attached with this endometrial lining. So as this layer become diffuse, finally it make the structure to become attached with this lining, that is to this endometrial lining. And as this is ready to be attached, now this is called zona hatching. In this video we have seen how the morula is formed, that is after the zygote formation, the 16 cell stage structure which is lying in the uterine tube, morulized form, and how this morula becomes the blastocyst. In my next video, I will be showing you how this blastocyst get implanted in this endometrial lining, that is in the innermost lining of the uterus, and how this endometrium now to be called as deciduum. Thank you.